Praise the name of Jesus. I believe you are well. The Lord has been faithful. Shalom to you. Greetings in the name of the Most High God. This morning we're talking about rebellion leads to destruction. Rebellion leads to destruction. Let's pray as we thank God for this word. Thank you, Father, for the word of today. Thank you, Father, for the beloved who have joined us for this morning session. May your blessings come upon them. May you bless them in and out. Lord, remember them in everything they ask of you. You are God who is faithful. Remain to be faithful to us, O God. Help us, King of glory, even as we hear your word. May this word correct us, O God. May this word align us, O Father. May King of glory also take us back to the path and follow the process, my Father, even as you share with us. In Jesus' name we pray. Amen. So God bless you. Rebellion leads to destruction. Rebellion is basically, to resist. To rebel is to resist. Or what we can basically say, to refuse to go a certain way. Resisting, refusing, and turning against something, and so on and so forth. Now, the Bible says in the book of 1 Samuel 15 and 23, you see, for rebellion is the sin of witchcraft. For rebellion is the sin of witchcraft, and stubbornness is as iniquity and idolatry. Because thou hast rejected the word of the Lord, he has also rejected thee from being king. Now, there are very many forms of rebellion. And you see, sometimes you may not know if you're rebelling against something until someone will let you know or you are able to be corrected. And we are seeing many areas of rebellion in different circumstances. And as we say, rebellion is resistance towards a person or group of persons in authority. It is characterized by refusal to obey or carry out the instruction of the leader. If you refuse to carry out the instruction of the leader, if you refuse to obey, if you refuse to, focus, what the leader is, focusing you on, then this is rebellion. And it tends to set a parallel, authority to which often leads to confusion, disorderliness, confrontation, and war. Rebellion can actually lead to war. It can lead to, disobedience. It can lead to, disorderliness, confusion, and many other things. Now, for God is not the author of confusion. That is the book of 1 Corinthians 14:33. For God is not the author of confusion, but of peace, as in all churches of the saints. Romans 13, 1 to 2. Let every soul be subject unto higher powers, for there is no power but of God. The powers that be are ordained of God. Whosoever therefore resisteth the power, resisteth the ordinance of God. And they that resist shall receive to themselves damnation. God is not an author of confusion. We are seeing many people who rebel against authorities, rebel against your leader, against your boss, rebel against authorities, people in power. You rebel against all those things. We are saying, do not rebel. God is teaching us this morning that rebellion leads to war and confusion and other bad things. But you need to be under authorities. Romans has spoken to us that, you see, everyone is supposed to be subject to the higher powers, for there is no power but of God. The powers that are ordained of God. Any person has been put before you as a leader, you need to obey them. You need to really respect them. There are many times that you, of course, differ in opinions, differ in ideas, differ in many things. That is okay. But remain to be faithful and obedient to those people. They might be of different state. They might be of a different understanding with you. They might be of a different, background. They might be of a different level of education. But we are saying, and what the Bible is quoting us this morning, helping us, is we have to be subject to the governing authorities. Lead by example. Be ready to be led. We always talk about teachable spirit. Teachable spirit is, having a spirit where you want to be taught and aligned. You want to be guided. There are many people who never want to be guided. There are people who want to, you know, do things in their own style. There are people who you'll always find it's like they know it all. They can't be guided, they can't be taught, they can't be led. Now, there is a people talking about this morning. If you're such a person with a rebellious spirit, with this person who can't be taught, who can't be, you know, guided, God is talking to us this morning saying, please be subject to governing authorities. Respect the leader. Respect those who are, you know, leading you. They might not be very qualified the way you're supposed to, or you might have a higher qualification than them. But you know what? You've got to be subject on that people. You have to be, you know, led. You have to understand that this is what God is speaking to us. He wants us to obey authority. Hallelujah. Now, common virtues of rebellion, or common features of rebellion. Number one is pride. When you see you are full of pride, then you can't be guided. And the book of 1 Peter 5:5 talks about that. Number two, stubbornness. There are people who are generally stubborn. They are told this, but they don't want to do. They are told this, they can't do. That the spirit of stubbornness is what we're talking about. It leads to rebellion and it leads to, you know, confusion and many other things. Number three, disobedience. Features of people who always rebel. Pride. We're talking about stubbornness, we're talking about disobedience, we're talking about the evil ambition, we're talking about lying. Yeah, you find many people have a lying tongue. And let me tell you, lying is very addictive. If you get used to lying every now and then, you say this, you say this, you say this, every time your tongue is used to lying. In fact, there are people who can't stay a day without lying because it is part of them. God is warning us. Stop lying, stop being stubborn, stop being disobedient, stop being, full of pride, stop being having evil ambitions, you know, stop being this person who is always disgraceful, having disgraceful ending. We always need to understand that by these things, they lead us to destruction. But when we pursue guidance, when we are led, when we follow the authorities, then we shall be great people and God is going to bless us so much. And therefore, this morning, we are saying, please, lead by example. How are you supposed to be led? Would you want to be led the way you're leading others? Would you want things done the way you're doing it? No. Then, if that is the case, that person has been put ahead of you. Please respect them, and once you do that, it will be pleasing our Father. I want to pray for you so that you can be able to be this person, because you know the beauty about life is life changes. Tomorrow you'll be under someone, and in the next minute you'll be leading other people. And the same things you do to this person, they'll also come upon you. So make sure that everything that you've given and God gives you, it is subject to, you know, being led in the right way. You are guided, you are corrected with love. You know, you don't lie, you're not stubborn, you're following things, and the truth of the matter is things will come to pass. I want us to pray and tell God, help us not to be rebellious. And we see rebellion even in church today. The churches also have rebellion. You find this person looks like he's better than the other person. We have these men of God who maybe they feel, I am better than this other person. We have maybe people in worship teams. They feel, I can sing better than the other person. We have people who, you know, in different, like even in media, I can record than the other person. We have people in ushering, I can usher people than the other person. You know, maybe even in youth, I can be the best. So everyone wants to compete. Now, this spirit is saying about God is warning us, we should not have this spirit of, you know, rebelling against each other. If you have a leader, stay under leadership. Stay under correction, and you shall actually go far. Everyone has been given gifts, and these gifts work for the glory of God. Let us not compete in church. Let us not compete in departments. Let us compete in places of, you know, work. God is saying he has given us different responsibilities, different gifts for the glory of God. If you do this and help each other, because remember one thing, we are focused in one goal. We are heading in one direction. But you know, sometimes we behave as if we are headed in different directions. Everyone wants to be superior. Everyone wants to feel like this is what is supposed to be done. Everyone wants to have their opinion heard. Well, this is okay. But is it for the glory of God? Or are we doing it for our own selfish interest? We are saying, let's not let our hearts, you know, go that direction of rebellion, but let our hearts be under submission and authority, to be guided so that God can still remain to be our Father in our lives. God bless you this morning. And even as we do that, I want to quote the book of 1 Samuel 15:23 as we conclude. 1 Samuel 15:23, the Bible says, "Whosoever therefore resisteth the power, resisteth the ordinance of God. And they that resisted shall receive of themselves damnation." Romans 13:2. Christians are expected to obey the constituted authority placed over them. Okay? Please respect what is put under you, and God is going to bless you. Shall we pray in the name of Jesus? Our Heavenly Father, we thank you. Thank you for this word about rebellion. I pray the Lord, you're going to help us. We have come to a time that many people are raising against each other the spirit, oh God, upon members in churches, in employment and other places. Lord, correct us, oh Father. May every spirit of rebellion be submitted and be suppressed, oh God. May we come against, and speak against the spirit of confusion in the holy places, oh God. The spirit of, know it all, my Father. The spirit of disobedience and pride. We come against them in the name of Jesus Christ. We pray the Lord, may our hearts submit unto thee. May we submit to our leaders. Correct us, oh Father. Where we have gone wrong, forgive us. King of Lord, we pray the Lord, the people watching and our friends and our beloved, they will align to this word because you are faithful. When we submit before the Lord, we shall be able to be given even greater and higher responsibilities for others as well. We thank you and we honor you. In Jesus' name we pray. Amen. God bless you. God bless you. I believe you have been blessed, and may God be with you in the name of Jesus Christ. Amen.